Hello, I'm Drewmatth, a master slash grandmaster player on Europe, Nordic and East, and today I want to go over two games that I played in solo queue as Talia mid. In the first game I was fairly sure I was going to win from champ select, and in the second game I thought I was fairly sure I was going to win, but I was wrong. We will talk in this video about dodging, counters, risks or gambling, macro and how to identify your team's strong players and their team's weaker players. We try to identify such players to play with them if they are our teammates and carry together, or profit from the lack of skill or experience from the enemy team weaker links. In League of Legends, when you are in champ select in solo queue, you generally pick, I hope, something that you know how to play or you at least have a decent experience on it. If you strive to improve, you never first try champions and you also think about general team composition and draft. Some players, as we all seen it before, don't care that about it that much. They either have a rough day, they want to try something new for some reason in solo queue, they got their main banned, or they simply want to troll by picking a champion that they don't know how to play, or they know it and they get heavily countered. I won countless games simply because I laned against someone who got their main banned, see Katarina for example. In general, if you get your main banned or you get heavily counterpicked, you can simply leave champ select at the cost of 3 LP or 10 LP if you dodged already. A lot of people don't even use their daily dodge and take a risk, a gamble, and grind on the hope that they can somehow win an impossible matchup on their well-known champion or on their first timing attempt. When you are in champ select, you can generally see your team's general stats on stuff like multi-query on op.gg. If you want to generally improve, this tool should be used at all times because you can see if a teammate of yours is first timing, trolling or is heavily tilting. In our first game example, I've seen the enemy team pick Irelia and that my team picked Wukong. That's how the draft started. I wasn't generally sure if Wukong counters Irelia, so I took a quick look on a site like u.gg where you could see stats and voila, Irelia had a 40% win rate against Wukong. I also noted that my Wu is fairly good player from his stats that would at least not int. I am not affiliated with the sites that I just mentioned, by the way. Whenever you think like this, consider calculating a gamble or risk factor. By seeing this thing, I could practically gamble the entire thing on the top lane because it relies insanely hard to play in teamfights, and all that I needed was my top laner to not int early, and stats confirmed it. I did not know at the time that Irelia is also sort of first timing, and so that just made everything 10 times easier because I could focus my playstyle around that side of the map once the game started. So this is the lesson: profit from the inexperienced players, find the weak links in the enemy team. Draft continued and we now see Anunu into Kayn, Talia versus Viktor and Senna Janna into Jinx Leona. Unless Kayn goes blue and gets a bit ahead, we should absolutely demolish early game until Kayn becomes rather useful, and that's what exactly happened. It's settled. What we have to do is move around the map early with Nunu and get kills everywhere because we basically have won the draft heavily in terms of early presence. They gambled on the fact that they can get into the mid game, we gambled on the fact that they cannot. If I were in their team champ select, I would have likely dodged, partially because Kayn and Irelia are not OTPs or particularly experienced on their champs, and also because our draft is terrible if I were in their team. The only case where we would have had chances to lose was if Irelia and Kayn were insanely good players and they would win their lanes early because either top or bot would int. I exclude myself because Kayn rarely has chances to gank a mid Viktor early on to get kills. In this game, we did a better draft, we found the weak links, we moved a lot around the map because that's what our comp does with Nunu and Talia, and we abused the weak links, Irelia's susceptibility to gank syndrome and Kayn's not dodging combos properly because he's not a main. In this particular game, maybe their mid or bot was their weak link, let's just say. You should find that from any live game statistics site and try to target that specific player if he has a tendency to int or a bad day. I lost a lot of experience in CS in the mid lane with the roams, but they lost the game. Mind also the fact that it matters who you put kills on. If their Jinx was their weak member, and you put 3 kills on Nunu and 2 on your Janna when you gank bot, then you don't really solve much. Try to get kills to whoever your carry is. I specifically say that to my tanks that they should pass the kills, for example Nunu, and it tends to work. Even in the higher elos, some people don't generally know that, and it pains me. Here is a thought template that you could use. Ask yourself in every champ select some of these questions. You can write them down, by the way. Is this draft okay? What are our weak lanes? What are our prior or strong lanes? See if it outnumbers the weak lanes. What is our team comp supposed to do? Do we play front to back? Do we poke? Do we flank or pick? What is our team's purpose? What is our win condition? And finally, should I dodge? This is your game plan here. From these questions, you need to draw your game plan. You should adjust your playstyle around this gameplay. If you play Lia, for example, you gain the strong side lanes unless you see an insane opportunity on a weak side lane. After many games, it should come naturally to you. Pro players know this almost mechanically already because of their enormous experience and skill level. You can too, with practice. You have statistics for your teammates before the game starts and even for opponents after the game starts, so use them. In the second game example, we see a draft again. They pick Garen, we pick Malphite. We have Viego into Blue Kane, Thalia into Yone, Karthus and Zyra into Xayah and Janna. We lost the game heavily and this was a very dodgeable game, so why I did not see that at the time? Some reasons that I think of could be: I wrongly assume that my Malphite will deal more damage in the game and know how to sort of do his job, which is jump on the Kane. This should have been seen by the fact that he does not have many games with Malphite. Even if it has a relatively simple champion, Malphite is simple, it matters a lot more to have some experience on it. I wrongly assumed also that my Viego, who had decent stats, could beat a Blue Kane. Viego being new, I don't have that much knowledge or experience about how he would work into many matchups. And also, I did not calculate the fact that their bot lane will output a lot more damage than ours even when heavily inting. I assumed I could go gank bot and win it, but I did not assume that they would still do so much damage. We lost the draft heavily, and while I did decently fine against Yone, such as more damage, more kill participation, not dying to him 1v1, and while Viego did Viego things in mid game, we still couldn't do more than them because their comp is superior to ours in most ways. We correctly identified our weak links, Malphite, and their weak link, Karthus, and while we did successful roams, in the end it didn't matter, because their scaling was much, much better than ours. We didn't have the damage in the mid game to keep up. Try to make this a constant exercise to assess in champ select what we discussed through the video. Try to think macro wise what is the strong lane or who or what will be the win condition and move there. Do that. Do it. Focus on it. And also dodge when absolutely necessary, because you can see cases when there is an absolute need for it. Alright guys, this is it. If I see people react positively to this, I might do more in this series, and I really hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching guys, goodbye.